Hey everyone, it's JJ from Filmora here to empower your inner video creator. And yes, we are back with another episode of You Ask, We Answer, the series where we answer the questions that you guys leave us in the comments section of our videos. So before I get into the questions, I just wanted to remind you guys of our latest version update 9.2. It is awesome. It has the render button, has split screens with animation, a shared media library, and more. So many of you guys have been asking, how do you get version 9.2? Well, you can download the update at the website at filmora.wondershare.com, or I will link them all in the description box below. So make sure you update. Okay, so let's get on to our questions. YouTube red bag is back. Okay. All right, so the first question comes from Omar Castillo. What is the function of the marker? So great question. So some of you guys were shocked that Filmora 9 has markers. It's pretty cool. So let me show you what they're for. The marker feature helps you organize while you edit. You can drop markers both on the timeline or in a clip. Markers can be used for many things. For example, marking a point in your footage to come back to later to fix or review. You can use markers to also mark points where you want to replace footage or places where you want to remind yourself where you want a voiceover to start. So there are so many different possibilities of how you can use markers. It all depends on how it can help you save time while you edit. So there you go. All right. So the next question comes from STEM Channel. Hi, I'm using Filmora's screen recorder. When I use a recorded video in Filmora 9, the voice doesn't work. I'm not sure why. The voice recording also doesn't work. Can you tell what I can do to solve the problem? Okay, so when you record in Filmora 9, here are some things to look out for. So when you're doing a screen recording, before you start, a box will appear to check the settings, like the resolution, headphones, and external mic. Plug in your mic into your desktop and make sure the external mic or the name of your mic device is selected. You can also test to see if the mic is working by speaking into the mic. The dots beside the mic should light up with the color to indicate that the mic is working and the volume of the recording. So make sure you double check that before you record, or you could do a test recording to see if all everything is working before you start recording. It's a good way to make sure everything is all good. Okay, next question. Okay. So this next question comes from Indian Review and Repair. Hi JJ.
Hello.
What is the use of blue screen and can I use it to replace green screen? Thanks, love from India. So yes, you can use a blue screen instead of a green screen. It all depends on the scenario that you're gonna use it for. So for example, if someone has to wear green or if the actor is blonde, they usually use a blue screen. So why do we use blue or green in green screens? Well, blue and green is the furthest color in the visual spectrum from red, which is the main color in human skin tones. So when you key out the blue or green, you won't have to worry about your skin being keyed out in the background. So you can use either blue or green screen for your background. Just make sure that you aren't wearing the same color as your background or else that will be keyed out too. And that's gonna look weird. Just make sure, okay? All right, so the next question comes from Ambao. I love this software, thank you, Elliot. Well, on behalf of Elliot, he says you're welcome. My question is, me and my friends want to react on video, but we want to do it the video full frame background. We want to use green screen and we can add our video in front. Is it possible in Filmora? So I think what you're trying to do is add a reaction video to a background. And yes, you can do that with picture in picture. So let me go ahead and show you how to do that in Filmora. First, add your background video to a track in the timeline. Next, in another track above the background video, drag and drop your reaction video. Double click on the reaction video in the timeline and then the editing options will appear in the upper left panel. Adjust the size and the position of your reaction video using the transform section and place the reaction video wherever you want it to appear on screen. Make sure your reaction video is synced up to the background video and voila, a reaction video. All right, so this question comes from Fixie. How to use and tips for image masking on Filmora Pro, please. All right, so masking is now available in Filmora Pro and Johnny has made a video on how to use masking in Filmora Pro, which you can watch up here. So go ahead and watch it there. And that's all of our questions for today. Thank you guys so much for asking them. Make sure to keep on asking them because we wanna know what you guys wanna know. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to our channel and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.